Hilary Duff called someone out on her Instagram. Let's take a look.
Calling all New Yorkers with asshole neighbors. Really open to any advice you have. My neighbor smokes cigarettes and weed all night long. My apartment reeks. Seriously, what do I do?
We know your parents pay your rent. We know you've never worked a day in your life. You must be nice. Have some respect for your neighbors who work hard to live in that building. Don't be a dick, dude. And put your trash down the chute.
Dieter, get a vape. What do you guys think? Five words or less.
Don't be a dick, dude.
Wait till I tell you.
Lizzie McGuire is not the one.
One post would have been enough.
But see,
it's
she's
so
that
much.
She's that
it's
crazy
this a
Libra.
Is non-smoking apartment rule? Is that because we don't know like everything? I was really trying to figure out if it is a rule where you move into this apartment and you are not allowed to smoke in your apartment. I don't like cigarette smoke either. I think it's gross, but. People forget that when you choose to share walls with another human being, that it's not like living in a house. And a lot of the times it sucks. But where does it stop if those are not the rules?
Which I do agree with you to a little, some extent. However, my mom lives in an apartment complex with someone who smokes a lot below her. And I think there comes to a point as an adult where you have to realize that, yes, even though you are paying rent to live in this space, there are still other people that are existing around. You should be cognizant and a little bit more considerate of those people, especially in 2018 and for the last 30 years where we know that smoking and secondhand smoke kills. I think you have a responsibility to do that if you're gonna smoke. I don't give a damn if it's inside or outside. So, right, Hilary Duff, she did drag this dude a little bit. Lizzie, you dragged him a little bit. But maybe they had words before. We don't know the whole story, what transpired before she got to this boiling point.
Have you ever gotten to this boiling point with
Absolutely.
Your neighbors?
Absolutely.
Oh, you guys wanna hear my crazy neighbor story?
Yes.
All right, I lived in Philly, in this high rise in Philly in Center City. And it was my birthday weekend, so my best friend's in town. A couple of my other friends are coming over. They're all coming in from New York. We are in the 1 p.m. on a Saturday. So, and I get it. Don't play loud music after 10 o'clock. I'm fine with that. But loud music, you got to chill out at 1 p.m. on a Saturday. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you're just going to have to hear your neighbors because you share
walls. Yes. Oh, got
walls.
It. Yeah, for sure.
And so it's 1 p.m. We have music playing. We are in the bathroom. My best friend's in the shower. I'm in front of the mirror, like doing my hair or makeup or something like that. Next thing you know, I hear, hello, hello. And it's really clear. And I was like, that's weird. So I have like my robe and it's like half undone. It's just me and my best friend. And so I walk out like robe undone, boom, in my living room, the front security person and my next door neighbor.
Oh,
in
wow.
My living room, because they are both nuts. I'm still mad about this. The lady next door was complaining about the music, I guess. And she had come and knock on my door and I couldn't hear because the music was loud.
Mm-hmm.
And she then went downstairs. Because this is just ruining her Saturday.
Yes.
Like, lady, go for a walk. Mm. But she goes downstairs, and the security guard is an idiot, and then decides to take the master key because she
That's
was
not worried. Okay.
And they unlocked my door and walked in, and were standing in my living room. Well, we didn't know. I was like, you do not use the master key to come in my house over some loud music at 1 p.m. on a Saturday. And she was like, well, you could have been in here being murdered. You couldn't hear us. First of all, if a murderer got up here, again, that's your fault.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah. And two, what are you going to do without your weapon? We're all going to be dead.
Right.
Now nobody's
so
going to call
weird.
The police.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, they can't play the like.
You
we didn't know there was anyone here.
You don't get to come into my apartment over loud music.
You're still so mad at this.
I am still so mad. This is nuts.
I think I can actually top that one though.
Okay.
Bring it.
Okay. So Lizzie and I recently moved in together this fall. We found the place. We moved in November, but we like put the deposit down in October so we could move in slowly, just because we really wanted to get this place. So we would go and drop off stuff at the house before we were even sleeping there. So we hadn't spent any nights there or anything. And Lizzie would go when she was off work and all that stuff. So I was coming home from here, from Pop Trigger, and Lizzie was like, oh, I'm just gonna unload some stuff at the apartment. And then my phone starts buzzing and Lizzie's like, like, I just had a terrible encounter with our neighbor. Please get here. I'm afraid. And I was like, oh my gosh, like what happened? And then I come in and she's like, get inside. And I'm inside and she's like, what happened? She's like, well, I was loading some stuff in and I saw this woman sitting on the curb to the next, you know, to the curb. And I thought she was on the phone and she was just like yelling expletives. And we live in a city. And so sometimes you like see people having bad days on the phone. And then finally Lizzie was coming back and forth, emptying out stuff. And then the woman said, B word, I'm talking to you. And just saying filthy, awful stuff to Lizzie. So Lizzie like gets her stuff and like just, you know, runs inside and closes the door. The woman comes around to our gate. Now this will make sense if you've like seen my our place. So we have like hedges and then there's like a side gate. So she comes around into our driveway at the gate and is like gesturing to Lizzie so like Lizzie can see her through the window and is like, get out here. Like I'm talking to you. This is your neighbor. Like get out here. So Lizzie's like pokes her head and she's like, hey, is everything okay? And she's like, yeah, I guess like I'm your neighbor with the view. And Lizzie's like, I don't know what you're talking about. And she's like, oh, you know, where my dog was before he died. I think you killed my dog. And Lizzie was like,
oh my God.
Lizzie was like, what are you talking about? She was like, yeah, I know that you complained to your landlord to tell my landlord that you didn't like the view of my dog laying out in the sun. Because I live in a house, but there's like, we share like a fence, basically. And so there apparently like her dog would lay out and she thought that we would like complain
to tan
and that we wanted to like put up a fence or something like that, which none of this could have conceivably happened because we'd never even spent a night there. So like we don't know what the views
and
are.
You're the last people to complain about dogs.
Right. And like we would complain about the view of a dog. I'm like, let's join the party.
Even complain about the view of the TV show.
Yes, exactly. So Lizzie, and she was like, yeah, like my dog all of a sudden, like ever since you guys have like moved in or whatever, which we hadn't even moved in yet, like my dog has been getting sick and sicker and sicker, and I'm a lawyer and I'm going to like have a dog autopsy and I'm going to prosecute this, to which Lizzie responds, well, I'm also an attorney. And she just apparently was just like, good. Like she probably wasn't expecting, like I am also a past the California bar.
And jury's like me. Karma
killed your dog, neighbor.
So then I get there and I'm like, we need to sort this out. We reach out to our neighbor next door to like explain what happened. They're a very nice older gay couple. So we're all in the family here. And he's like, this is not how you guys are going to like understand our neighborhood. We have a lovely community here. Let's go over
this
and talk to them.
This story is so long.
I'm sorry. Okay. So it's just alive and well in my brain. So then we go next
door. Special two-hour edition of Pop Trigger today.
Of neighbor encounters.
This is part one of nine.
It's almost done. So then we go next door.
Like trapped in the closet.
I'm like this.
We go next door to the neighbor and we knock on the door. She doesn't answer, but her boyfriend answers, and they're like all there. We like hear sobbing from the inside. We're like, oh, this happened, and he's like, I'm sorry, the dog was 15 years old. I don't know why. I'm sorry that she yelled at you. And then since then, we have only ever heard her. We've never seen her. But she got a new dog, and she just yells and curses at this dog all the time. She didn't even take care of the dog.
My neighbor.
End of it now.
That was harrowing.
And harrowing. I'm glad Lizzie's okay.
It's a great way to move into a neighborhood and someone says, you killed my dog, you whore.
Yeah. She was calling her the C word.
Before we moved out of our condo.
The C word.
Bedrooms would face another window, right? Mm-hmm. So our neighbor, before we moved out, he comes out and he says, when you guys first moved in, I used to enjoy watching you guys have sex because we had no one was living there. We had no curtains on. It was,
amazing.
It was two stories up. So he's like, thank you for that. And that was the last time we heard from that.
All right, you win. That was pretty good.
That's a happy story.
Yeah.
I understand this story, the Lizzie McGuire one, whatever, Hilary Duff. Because with neighbors like this, you don't start off blasting them, putting them on blast on Instagram. You start off just being like, it's kind of annoying.
But is Hilary Lizzie or is she your crazy neighbor? Because it's looking a little bit like.
I don't think she's crazy, you guys.
I have one story, but it's gonna take a few seconds. Across the street from us, there was a Navy SEAL and someone with a rooster. And the rooster kept crowing very early in the morning. And the Navy SEAL's like, stop that. Please freaking stop that. And he's like, if you don't stop it, I'll do it myself. So one day they heard the Navy SEAL had shot the bird with a crossbow.